Okay. See, today let us start the exercise 3.5. See the question, which of the following pairs of linear equations has a unique solution, no solution, or infinitely many solutions? In the previous class, we have learned about the conditions of unique solution. Condition for unique solution is a1 by a2 is not equals to b1 by b2. Condition for unique solution. Then no solution. No solution means a1 by a2 equals to b1 by b2 is not equals to c1 by c2. Then or infinitely many many solutions. See, infinitely many solutions, there will be condition like a1 by a2 equals to b1 by b2, that is equals to c1 by c2. You know all these conditions. In the previous class we have solved so many problems related to these conditions. Okay, now we have to check the given pair of linear equations, whether the pair of linear equations are applicable to this one, applicable to this one, or applicable to this one. If the pair of linear equations have unique solution, then only we have to find the value of x and y by using the multiplication, cross multiplication method. Once again I will show you the how to set the cross multiplication formula for solving the x and y. Already you know that the equation first has a1 and a2, x column has a1 and a2, then b1 and b2, y column as b1 and b2, then constant column as c1, c2. See, we have to consider these columns as 1, 2, 3. By using 2, 3, 1, 2 rule, by using 2, 3, 1, 2 rule, using 2, 3, 1, 2 rule, this one is 1, this one is 2, this one is 3. Okay, first of all we have to write the coefficients containing equation 2, that is b1, b2, then 3, c1, c2, then 1, that is a1, a2, then again 2, that is b1, b2. Okay, prepare the coefficient and set like this what I have shown in the board. Okay, these base coefficients, underline it and think these are the signs, that is negative sign. Okay, first you draw the arrow mark like this, second one like this, continue in similar way. That is, I have completed the multiplication diagram. Then by using this diagram, we have to find the formula for x and the formula for y. Okay, what that actually x means? x equals to 1 divided by b1 c2, 1 divided by d1 c2, this is preceded by minus b2 c1, then y equals to, again similar way we have to move, c1 into a2 minus c2 into into A1. That is equals to 1 divided by A1 B2 minus A2 B1 into B1. If you have confusion, you put like this. X divided by B1 C2 minus B2 C1, Y divided by C1 A2 minus C2 A1, 1 divided by A1 B2 minus A2 B1. This represent X, this represent Y, this represent 1. Okay? This is the way of writing the cross multiplication formula. Okay? Let us use this formula in finding the value of the variables X and Y. X and Y. Okay? See, once again, I will continue the exercise. See attentively that. See, the first formula X, first one, X minus 3Y minus 3 equals to 0, 3X minus 9Y minus 2 equals to 0. What we have to do? We have to write the coefficients. Coefficient of X, A1, that is, nothing means 1. That is A2, which is equal to 3. Then B1, that is minus 3. Then B2, that is minus 9. Then C1, that is minus 3. Then C2, that is minus 2. See, we have to check the condition. That is, A1 by A2, let us write 1 by 3. B1 by B2 minus 3 divided by minus 9. 3 ones are 3 threes are. That is 1 by 3. C1 by C2, that is minus 3 minus 2, that is equal to 3 by 2. But A1 by A2 is not equals to A1 by A2 is equals to B1 by B2. B1 by B2. So it is not necessary to solve the pair of linear equation, because if A1 by A2 is not equals to B1 by B2, then only we have to use the cross multiplication method. Not possible. Not possible, because A1 by A2 is not equals to, because I will write in symbol. B1 by B2. This much is the solution for the first one. Okay, write down this one. Let us move to the second one. See, this one is the second one. 2x plus y equals to 5. Y equals to 5. Then 3x plus 2y. Equals to 8. Okay, now we have to write in the standard form. That means we have to bring that constant term into this side. That is 2x. Plus y minus 5 equals to 0. 3x plus 2y minus 8 equals to 0. Then as usual, A1 by A2 equals to 2 by 3. B1 by B2 equals to 1 by 2. Now, A1 by A2 is not equals to B1 by B2. Hence, we have to use the cross multiplication for this because the condition is satisfied. A1 by A2 is not equals to B1 by B2. Then we have to find the value of x and the value of y. Then let us write that C2 equals to minus 5 by minus 8. That is equals to 5 by 8. Okay. Now by using the cross multiplication method. A1 2 A2 3 A1 2 B1 1 B2 2 C1 minus 5 C2 minus 8. So B1 by B2 A2 B1 B2. X divided by B1 C2 minus B2 C1 equals to y divided by C1 A2 minus C2 A1. That is equals to 1 divided by that is B1 B2 minus A2 B1. This implies cross multiplication method. Cross multiplication method. Okay, let us fill the values. X equals to B1, that is 1, into C2, that is minus 8, minus then B2 is 2, into C1 minus 5, y divided by C1 that is minus 5 into A2 that is 2 that is 3 minus C2 that is minus 8 into A1 that is 2. A1 B2, A1 2 into 1, 2 into 2, minus A2 B1, 3 into 1, okay, x divided by minus 8, minus into minus, plus 10, then that is equals to y divided by minus 15 plus 8 to the 16, then that is equal to 1 divided by 4 minus 3. So x by 2 equals to y by 1 equals to 1 by 1. So this implies therefore x by 2 equals to 1, therefore x equals to cross multiplication, 2 ones are 2, y by 1 equals to 1, therefore y equals to by cross multiplication 1 1 1, therefore the solution set for pair of linear equation is x equals to 2, y equals to 1. See, the fourth one I am solving because third one is not suitable for the cross multiplication method because the condition a1 by a2 is not equals to b1 by b2 is not satisfied. So you try yourselves that third one. X minus 3y minus 7 equals to 0, 3x minus 3y minus 15 equals to 0. Don't solve everyone by multiplication method. There is a condition. In case a1 by a2 is not equals to b1 by b2, then only you have to use the multiplication method. Okay? Now, let us find a1, 1, a2, that is 3, then b1 minus 3, b2 minus 3, c1 minus 7, c2 then minus 15, a1 by a2 1 by 3, b1 by b2 minus 3 by minus 3, that is equal to 1. Therefore, a1 by a2 is not equals to b1 by b2. Therefore, cross multiplication is possible. Is possible. Okay, if cross multiplication is possible, let us use the cross multiplication for this solution. Okay, you know a b1 b2 c1 c2 a1 a2 again b1 b2, which method do you have used? 2-3-1-2 method. Okay, put the arrow mark. Two-three-one-two rule. So how we have to find x divided by b1 c2 minus b2 c1, y divided by that is c1 a2 minus c1 a2 minus c2 a1, 1 divided by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Okay, now let us put the values. X divided by b1, how much? Minus 3 into c2, that is minus 15. Then minus of b2, that is minus 3 into c1, that is minus 7. Goes to y divided by c1 minus 7 into a2, that is 3 minus c2, that is minus 15 into a1, that is 1 equals to 1 divided by a1, 1 into b2 minus 3 minus a2, that is 3 into a2 b1, that is minus 3. Okay, now x divided by 45 minus into minus plus minus 7 3s are 21 that is equals to y divided by minus 21, that is minus into minus plus 15 ones of 15, that is equals to 1 divided by minus 3 plus 3 threes are 9. Okay. Now x divided by, that is 24 equals to y divided by 6. Then equals to 1 divided by 6. Now x by 24 equals to 1 by 6. That implies x equals to 24 into 1 divided by 6. 6 ones are 6 fours are. That implies 4. Then y by minus 6 equals to 1 by 6. Therefore y equals to minus 6 by 6. 6 ones are 6 ones are. Therefore y equals to minus 1. See, x equals to 4, y equals to minus 1. See, you continue from here.